Welcome to the news. The news headline. How I predicted end of Abba Kyari, who killed innocent Biya fans, Simon Ekpa says. The details. A self-acclaimed disciple of Nnamdi Kanu, the 10th leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, HIPOP, Simon Ekpa has claimed that he earlier predicted that DCP Abba Kyari would be disgraced for allegedly killing innocent Igbos. Recall that the former commander of the Inspector General of Police Intelligence Response Team, IGP IRT, who served in the Southeast but was suspended over alleged tie with an internet fraudster, Abbas Ramon, popularly known as Hush Puppy, was arrested by the Nigeria police on Monday. His arrest was sequel to fresh allegations against him on drug trafficking. As the National Drug Law Enforcement Agency, NDLEA, declared him wanted for allegedly working with two international drug couriers identified as Chibuna Patrick Umebi and Emeka Afonus. He was subsequently arrested by the police and handed over to the NDLEA as more investigations continue. Reacting, Ekpa, in a tweet on his official Twitter handle on Monday, described the embattled cop as a criminal who, according to him, had killed innocent Biafrans. The tweet reads, "I called Abba Kyari a criminal even before the indictment in the US. I told him that for killing Biafrans, he would be disgraced and his career will end in Biafra land. Today, is he not known globally as a criminal? The big question is, what happened to all the innocent Biafrans he killed?" The self-acclaimed disciple of Nnamdi Kanu said that he either made it known to Abbas Kyari that very soon he will be disgraced, that he has been involved in the killing of the Biafrans. And remember that Abba Kyari has been traced down to Hush Puppy concerning fraud, and now it has been traced again that he is dealing with some drugs people that are importing drugs illicitly. This is a superior cop, someone who is supposed to be a leader in the society, a discipline for that matter, someone who is supposed to not go against the laws. He knows the laws and the rules of the country, yet is going against those laws. Why does Grace Super Cup cannot escape imprisonment? This is coming in when legal expert said that the former head of the Police Intelligence Response Team, Abba Kyari, is in fresh legal trouble after a sting operation by the officers of the NDLEA indicted him. Mr. Kyari, who is facing possible extradition to the US on cyber fraud related offenses, risks life imprisonment if convicted by a competent court for the offense of selling cocaine. The police on Monday arrested Kyari some hours after the NDLEA declared him wanted and released a video of him selling cocaine. According to the statement by the police, Kyari was indicted for official corruption, tampering with narcotic exhibits and other unprofessional conduct. Consequently, the police have handed Kyari to the police for further investigation and prosecution under the NDLEA Act. Part 2, Chapter 11 of the Act provides that A. Any person who without lawful authority imports, manufactures, plants, or grows the drugs popularly known as cocaine, LSD, heroin, and other similar drugs shall be guilty of an offense and is liable on conviction to imprisonment for life. B. Export, transport, or otherwise traffic in the drug popularly known as cocaine, LSD, heroin, or any other similar drugs shall be guilty of an offense and liable upon conviction to be sentenced to life imprisonment. C. Sells, buys, exposes, or offers for sales, or otherwise deals in or with the drug popularly known as cocaine, LSD, heroin, or any other similar drugs shall be guilty of an offense and liable on conviction to be sentenced to imprisonment for life. Section 16 of the Act also provides the punishment for tampering with evidence, which is one of the crimes Kyari is being accused of. On this count, Kyari risks 25 years imprisonment if convicted for evidence tampering. Speaking on the matter, a legal luminary, Enrikele Shuku, who spoke, said the chances of Kyari getting a prison term were high. Every case usually has loopholes to be exploited. However, this case is quite close-knitted. The reason is simply because the offenses for which he is being accused to have committed are offenses which have semblance of strict liability, where you need not to even prove intention. Of course, it depends on the charge which the prosecuting agency wants to prosecute him with. And this is coming in when police reveals identities of drug barons working with Kyari. The Nigeria Police Force has unraveled the identities of two drug barons working with the disgraced police chief Abba Kyari. The agency, in a statement signed by its media chief Femi Babafemi, revealed that Kyari was also caught on tape offering the bribe. The CP Kyari is a member of a drug cartel that operates the Brazil-Ethiopia-Nigeria illicit drug pipeline. The saga started on Friday, January 21, 2022, when the CP Kyari initiated a call to one of the NDLEA officers in Abuja at 2:12 p.m. When the officer returned the call 2 minutes later, Kyari informed him he was coming to see him to discuss an operational matter after the Jumat service. He appeared at the agreed venue of the meeting with the officer and went straight to the crux of the matter. This was it. His team had intercepted and arrested some traffickers that came into the country from Ethiopia, according to him, 25 kg of cocaine. He proposed a drug deal whereby he and his team had to take 15 kg of the cocaine and leave 10 kg for the prosecution of the suspect arrested with the illicit drug in Enugu. We have come to the end of the news. What's your take concerning Abba Kyari? Kindly share your thoughts. Thank you.